I was a really competitive kid. My parents could tell you that for sure. So that was kind of why I was motivated. I never really thought about it when I was younger. Even through high school, like I just liked competing. I liked to play. But the older you get, the more you realize like different things for motivation and why you do things. Like why am I going to this fall camp? You know, for 12 hours a day and beating the heck out of myself. Like why am I doing this?
Welcome back to another episode of The Burn. I couldn't be any more fired up to have this opportunity for you guys to meet a dear friend of mine, Kyle Emanuel. And we are right here in Fargo, North Dakota. He's back in Fargo, where he played football for the North Dakota State Bison. He was part of the teams that started the run that has created the absolute dynasty that has been a huge part of the story of college football, really over the last 8 years. Which then transcended to going on and playing for the Los Angeles Chargers for 4 years, being a starter, helping the team build back to a playoff football team. And one of the things that I've always loved about Kyle is coming from a small town in Schuyler, Nebraska, having great support of family, staying true to the disciplines to attack every single day. And what's unique is my 4 years working with the Bison football program, you didn't even play with the Bison. Right. So that's how special the Bison is. It's the relationships that you build by being part of something special. So also, Buck Buchanan Award winner, so the best defensive player in college football. And what I really want to do, I want to start with a pretty cool story because I want people to understand your burn, because what many people don't realize is that, and they used to say this at the rookie symposiums, you have a better chance of getting struck by lightning than playing in the NFL. And you are a humble guy. You are a humble dude. You're a humble dude, and I'm going to try to get you to open up a little bit more because you've done the work, and you did something that many people never have the opportunity to do. So I want to understand, like, what was the burn? And then we cannot forget to talk about Jabbar Kane, one of our dear friends, who is your coach on your defensive coach, really for your position at linebacker in college, and he really challenged the heck out of you, which we all get challenged, but we choose how we show up to the challenge. So if you could start with, what's really that burn been for the motivation to do what you've done, and then we're going to tie up with that Jabbar Kane story.
Yeah, so I didn't really get introduced to my why, which is what I talk about, you know, my why did I play, why did I do the things I did until college. Really, when I was growing up, I was just a self-motivated kid. I really was. I wanted to be the best at everything. Like, I didn't even like school, but I wanted to get A's because I wanted to beat other people. Like, that's just how I was. So I was kind of, I don't know if you want to call that lucky or not, but I was a really competitive kid. My parents could tell you that for sure. So that was kind of why I was motivated. I never really thought about it when I was younger. Even through high school, like I just liked competing. I liked to play. But the older you get, the more you realize like different things for motivation and why you do things. Like why am I going to this fall camp, you know, for 12 hours a day and beating the heck out of myself? Like why am I doing this? And for me, like what I like to tell people is if you can find a reason bigger than yourself, If you do things not just for yourself, because you can let yourself down and it's easy, right? Like, I don't want to get up out of bed and do this, but I'm only cheating myself. When you realize you're cheating other people and when you're affecting other people, that for me was the biggest motivation. So when I got to college, Coach Kane actually talked about that. You're like, what is your why? And for me, it was my teammates, my brothers, the guys that had gone through all that hard work with me, and I knew what they had done, and I knew I didn't want to let them down because, like I said, I would have been cheating myself, I would have been cheating them. And then just being in Fargo and around this awesome community, the alumni, we talked a lot about the players that came before us that laid the foundation. Knowing that I would let them down if, you know, I'm not giving my best was a huge motivation for me. And, you know, that story you mentioned with Coach Caney, I walked in and talk about motivation. I had 7.5 sacks, you know, was second team all conference, thinking I had a decent year, and we had won 3 national championships, and he comes in and basically tells me that was nothing, you need to do better. And I was kind of like, who is this guy? What does he think he knows about, you know, I've won 3 national championships, like, what do you know? But him challenging me and setting a goal was another like, it was a big thing for me, and it kind of pushed me to that next level.
And the way he likes to tell the story is he really challenged you, like, man, if you really think you're going to get it, you need to go for 20 sacks.
Yeah.
Which you think 7.5 to 20,
seems
right?
Impossible.
So I think for so many people watching right now, they've accepted where they are, and maybe they push themselves and challenge themselves, but whatever your walk of life is, you're listening to this right now, you think of 7.5 to 20, it's like you're operating at 40% of what your potential is. So he literally looks at you, 3 national championships in a row, 7.5 sacks, and he's saying, wait a second, you could go for 20, but then you showed up and changed your work, and tell us how that story played out.
Yeah, well, it was funny because, like, I think at the time, you know, I'd been at NDSU for 4 years if you count my retro year, and I don't think anyone had over 10, maybe 11. And so when he comes in and says 20, I'm just, what is he talking about? Like, this just seemed insurmountable. Like, that's not possible. He's like, that's one a game, basically, you know, or a little more than one a game if you play in the playoffs. And it just seemed impossible. But, yeah, that kind of, it changed my attitude as far as the preparation. And I was already motivated, again, just by the fact that, you know, it was my senior year. I wanted to finish it off on the right foot. And I became intentional and focused on my workout and my lifting. And I was lifting at 5:30 in the morning, and I didn't always want to be there. But once I got there, I realized I had a job to do. I realized I had teammates that were counting on me. And that's really what I think changed, you know, my senior year, and I ended up with, you know, just short 19 and a half.
And 19 and a half catapulted you as one of the greatest defensive performances in the history of 1AA football and really college football all across the board. Buck Buchanan winner. And it really put you on the map. By focusing one day at a time, by accepting the challenge, it puts you on the map to be drafted in the 5th round by the San Diego Chargers, finishing as an L.A. Charger.
Yeah.
And, you know, you mentioned teamwork earlier, and I'd love for you to touch on this. You had to change positions a couple of times in your career, and I work with a lot of guys in the league. We know, you know, a lot of guys in the league. A lot of guys, you tell them to change the position, they change their tune, and they say, trade me.
Right.
Right? And you made a choice to do the opposite. So tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, I think that kind of goes back to just, you know, when I talked about my why and why I do things and talking about my teammates. And I always wanted to be a guy, and I said it, and I changed positions in college, too, right away. And I always said, like, I want to help the team win. I don't care what it was. I played a lot of positions in high school in football. I played a lot of positions in other sports. And I wanted to be that guy that they could count on if they need to switch someone, that you know, they could come to me and know that I would do that. And I thought, you know, not only did that add value, but again, you know, we talk about servant leadership and doing things without a motive or without a hidden agenda and wanting something back in return. That was kind of my way of being a servant leader. Like, hey, I realize, you know, we have some injuries or whatever it might be, and I'm gonna help out, you know, the guy next to me. I'm gonna help out the guys on the offense. You know, we're all in this together, trying to win a game. And if the coaches who are in charge think that me switching positions was gonna help us, that's what I wanted to do.
So I love and admire that team aspect. Love the hard work, but it's also mindset has meant a lot to you. And I think when we met after Coach Kane introduced us, said you guys got to meet. It's all Bison family here. Coming off of a season 4-12 as a rookie, you were not starting, and we talked about goal setting. Yep. And after we talked about goal setting, it was becoming a starter and being a starter on a playoff team, right? So you chose something that was personal and you chose something that was team.
Yep.
Both ended up happening in your final season. So take us to what it felt like to have all the hard work culminate in achieving those goals. Tell us a little bit about that. And then I know even though it didn't finish the way that you wanted, I think it's pretty unique what the story that you're going to be able to tell your kids.
Yeah, I mean, so going from college when you lose 3 games in 4 years to going 4-12, that really kind of pushed my why. And, you know, why am I still motivated to do this? And, you know, when we talked and I wrote that goal down, even then, you know, and I mentioned, like, I wish I would have went bigger. But at the time, it seemed so big. But I wanted to do something that was, I thought was possible, but also challenging. And for me, Being a starter was always a goal of mine. I wanted to be out on the field. I wanted to contribute. I wanted to help. But I also, you know, like we just talked about, I was a team guy, and I loved having team success. I love individual success, but if it comes without team success, it just didn't matter to me. So I wanted to include that in my goal, and to be able to accomplish that. Go from 4-12 to 12-4, win a playoff game, and then it was amazing. It really was. It was a culmination of a lot of hard work, and then to end it, it obviously didn't end the way we wanted to. We lost to the Patriots, who won the Super Bowl, but. I'll forever get a say that my last snap ever, granted it was a kneel down and we were losing by 20 plus, was, feet from Tom Brady. One of the greatest to do it. Talk about a guy who's motivated. It's kind of a cool story. Granted, I wish it was ending when we were winning or something. I got a game-ending interception or something like that. But a kneel down works as well.
Well, thank you so much for the example that you set. Thank you for your friendship. And thank you for what it means to the little guys and girls who have those dreams to go do something, really, really big in life, because you set that example. And I think it's great you being back in Fargo, doing your TV work, now being a speaker, that we're going to have the opportunity to continue to do more work there. It's just, I'm so excited for the next chapters, because with work ethic like yours, anything is possible. So I appreciate you.
Man. Yeah, absolutely.